whenever we went on tour, we always got the buses, you know, from Mankato. They would come down from that bus company and take us around. Although the first time we left campus, we went up to Marshall, Minnesota for our first concert because one of the girls' dad was the principal at Marshall High School. And we left Marshall to go to Eureka, South Dakota. And that was just after lunch. We served as lunch in high school. And before we got to South Dakota border, the bus stopped. And we sat there, and we sat there, and we sat there. You know, I'm from South Dakota, and the scenery is wonderful in western Minnesota and South Dakota. But we were supposed to be in Eureka for supper, too. And the bus driver had forgotten to switch on the next train. He finally dawned on it, so then we got started again. And we had a wonderful chicken dinner in Eureka. I remember that. We always sang a table prayer. Lord, we thank thee as our provider. So that's what we're going to do first. And then at the end of the meal, they always provided us such a nice meal at these churches. We thank them for the meal. So those are the first two. And we're doing it a little bit different, you know. We had that secret way of getting fish back in the days. But today we're going to use the piano for the fish. And you'll hear it too. So if you want to sing along, if you've heard the pitch, that's okay. So here's the table.
Thank you.
Saturday night, or a Sunday night for Christmas at Westmar. And we always have a different processional, and this one is called So Let It Shine.
Okay.
And she was able, because she came from Philadelphia, she was able to start out and have a bigger career in the United States and Roland. So he went to Europe and had a nice career. But that day, he sang for our campus on an evening concert. And at that time, we had the same kind of gym that Westmar had for many years. And we had wooden folding chairs that made a lot of noise when we left the chapel. But that night, he sang this recital, and then he came back at the end of the recital that wasn't on the program, and he came without his pianist, and he sang, "Were You There?" And that wonderful spiritual that you all know. And we talked about the Holy Spirit moving us, and somehow the Holy Spirit moved that audience. We did not make a sound after he was through singing. Nobody applauded, and he left the stage very quietly, and we got up from those wooden chairs, and, you know, usually students do a lot of talking, right? And we got up from our chairs without a sound. We walked out of that gymnasium, and we didn't even talk out on the sidewalk. We walked the block or so before. We were so moved by that. Well, as my good fortune would have it, one time when I was studying here at Westmar and working with the students, I was going to go to summer school at Boulder, and Roland Davies was teaching voice that summer, and I was able to study with him. And my lesson was the last hour at 2:30 on a Friday afternoon. And when I was through with my lesson at 3 o'clock, he would always say, "Are you in a rush?" And then I would walk over and sit beside him on the couch, and he would talk about his background growing up and his concertizing and all the different experiences with the black people having a problem wherever they went. And he told me about a book that he had written, and it was called Angel Moe and her son, that he and his mother had come together with. And so I went to the library, and I was able to find it in the Norland Library at the campus. And then Ruth and the three children read the story. Each night they read a little bit more of that book. And then when we gave a concert at the end of the summer, Jester Hairston, that some of you remember from the Amen, you know, he made that popular. Well, he had the Hollywood style of the Negro spiritual, and Roland Hayes said there are two approaches to spiritual. And this is our good fortune again. Roland Hayes and his wife sat right ahead of Ruth and the kids at the concert, so they got to meet him too. So that was fun. So that's a special thing to me, is the spiritual. So Bill Dickey from over in Wayne is going to sing the solo every time. I feel the spirit.
Oh,
Christine Curry, Pippin, not Pippin.
Boylan.
Boylan, from Ohio City, will be doing the solo on this one.
Thank you.
came to the auditorium and some wonderful concerts. And he did a lot of workshops around the country. One year, some of us went down to Lincoln, Nebraska, and a few years later, he was out at St. Cloud State. And this is one of the favorites that some of the students requested that we sing again today. It's called Still, Still, Still.
Thank you.
you can hum along with us if you would like. Beautiful Savior was kind of our tradition in the fun time in the church. And so thank you all for coming. We're having a wonderful weekend. And this is Beautiful Savior with Pam from Rochester, who sang with us in Berlin. She had a nice experience on television of having to start the choir and start over four times because of technical problems with the audio people back in the control department. There's that. Good band, but they're all over ready to sing the solo. And when she came her time, off we went. And the next week we were shopping in a little town in Berlin, away from Berlin, and the shopkeeper goes, "Wow, the people that were on TV."